terrorists, to be imprisoned and they're rehabilitated. They're treated like princes, allowed every luxury that they could ever desire. And the fact could be is so much farther away from what they say that it's impossible to state. Jail prison, massively overcrowded.
In 2012, the Bahraini government and criminal justice system has denaturalized 824 Bahraini citizens. This leaves these individuals stateless and puts any children born to stateless fathers at risk, as Bahraini women cannot pass on their nationality. Most of these denaturalizations occur through the criminal courts and have been imposed against Bahraini individuals who have likely been subjected to torture and fair trial rights violations. We stand in solidarity with these 824 Bahrainis and with so many others whose stories and struggles we do not know. Based on our documentation of hundreds of cases, average Bahraini's trials begin with a warrantless arrest, followed by a disappearance ranging from a few days to several months without formal charges against them. Bahraini officials subject them to torture to coerce a confession that is then used in the trial against them. They subject them to an unfair trial in which the detainee may not have had access to legal counsel. They sentence them, including up to life imprisonment and the death penalty, and strip their nationality. They are either sent to the women's prison at Isatown or Jail prison, where the administration denies them access to health care and medication. These abuses are not reserved for violent criminals. Rather, they occur on a widespread and systematic basis. Bahrain continues to hide behind the guise of counterterrorism to violate the basic human rights of its citizens.
Daily being tear gassed, daily being assaulted because people really believe that they wanted what we have here, this modicum of freedom, and they didn't have it. And they were willing to just keep going and standing and standing. And they're still standing, which is extraordinary. And that we're here with them. Some of you are Bahrain, and some of us have just had the good fortune to meet some of you and to take courage from you because we all need it. You know, the world we live in is not a place where democracy flourishes. And so I'm taking heart, and my sisters here from Code Pink are also taking heart, knowing that all around the world, there are you and we, all of us who are standing for a better world where people have freedom, where people are not imprisoned because they want freedom, because they want justice. So we'll stand together with you, and we ask you to stand together with us.
Who's tortured people? Do we have denial of health care for prisoners? Brutal beatings from veterans like Abdelhad Al-Khawaja. Let's talk about how no one's held accountable for these. We know some people who do this. We have their names, we have their positions, we know who they answer to. We know dates. We hear it from the families themselves. We have communicated this, and yet Bahrain does not do anything. This system goes all the way to the top. It's a government that works with impunity. It does not feel like it can, it's being held accountable. But we will hold it accountable. We've seen protests in Dublin, in London. We'll see protests in Berlin. We'll see hearings in Brussels and Ireland and here. This is a global issue. People care about what happens in Bahrain. These are human rights that are at stake. People's lives are at stake. Fundamental freedoms are at stake.
He was playing soccer for Bahrain, and they convicted him nonetheless using evidence that was obtained by torture. So they convicted him in 2014, and he fled to Australia and sought asylum. In 2017, he was granted this asylum status. This past November, he was arrested in Thailand as soon as he arrived in the airport. This was on the basis of an international red notice from Interpol that should never have been put against him in the first place because as a refugee, he has certain protections under international law. So he was taken and he was held arbitrarily detained for 76 days until the Bahraini government finally, after international pressure, just like this, decided that they were going to remove the extradition order against him. But we maintain that he should never have been detained in the first place. And so he was arbitrarily detained for 76 days, despite the fact that he was a refugee.
What work